Mike Stevens and North Carolina State already own two victories over ranked teams for the first time since 2006. Grant Halvorsong at Images 3 months ago during ACC Football Media Day, Bradley Chubb fielded a question about North Carolina State's identity. "We just want to be that team that you don't want to play," the senior defensive end said. Chubb's concise answer has proved prescient on the heels of the Wolfpack's fifth consecutive victory, 3,925 last week against visiting Louisville, which helped push NC State's national ranking to 20th and kept it in step with number 2 Clemson atop the ACC Atlantic Division. A 51 mark might not have been totally unexpected for a group that returned 16 starters from a 76 team. But the demands of its division, which features defending national champion Clemson, perennial contender Florida State and Louisville, led by returning Heisman Trophy winner Lamar Jackson, figured to keep NC State locked a notch below. So did its history. The Wolfpack has earned a bowl berth in 5 of the past 6 seasons but lost at least 5 games each year. It has never finished a season ranked higher than number 12 nor won more than 11 games, both of which it achieved in 2002. In the 14 full seasons since, its record was 8,887. That gives some indication of the excitement over this season's start. The Wolfpack has defeated 2 ranked teams in the same season, number 12 Florida State on September 23 and number 17 Louisville last week for the first time since 2006. Its 30th start in the ACC is its best since that 2002 team, which finished 113, began 40 in league play. "They don't want to be denied what they feel like is theirs right now," Wolfpack coach Dave Doran said of his players. "They've had to learn what the word perseverance means. It's one of our core values. You don't just choose to persevere. You have to have adversity. You have to have struggle. You have to face your fears, and to do that you have to grow up, and you've got to dig deep." NC State stared down just such a challenge when preseason hopes gave way to a season-opening loss to South Carolina, 3,528, on September 2 in Charlotte. Following the game, in which the Wolfpack doubled up the Gamecocks in yards but fell short after reaching the opposing 8-yard line in the final seconds, Doran asked his players in the locker room whether that effort was the best they could have mustered. A resounding no was the response. Offensive players were particularly disappointed in having lost 2 fumbles in the opener. "They have committed 1 turnover since, including no interceptions for quarterback Ryan Finley." The redshirt senior has been especially efficient against ranked opponents, going a combined 42-for-63 66.7% with 597 yards and 3 touchdowns in the matchups with Florida State and Louisville. Finley threw for 367 yards against the Cardinals as NC State rolled up 520 yards of offense and its second most points this season. 3 players had at least 99 receiving yards: Kelvin Harmon with 133, Jalen Samuels with 104 and Stephen Lewis with 99. Nyheim Hines, a Doetal player for ascending offensive coordinator Aliyah Drinkwitz, added 102 rushing yards and 2 touchdowns on 18 carries. "We have so many weapons on offense, and I think it's just a matter of executing," redshirt junior guard Garrett Bradbury said. "If Ryan wants to throw for 450 yards a game, he can. If we want to run the ball for 250 yards a game, we believe we can." With wins over 2 of its most prominent foes, a breakthrough record appears within reach given what's left on the Wolfpack's schedule, beginning with Saturday afternoon's game against Pittsburgh 24-02 at Heinz Field. The Panthers are one of 3 remaining opponents for NC State that has yet to collect a conference win. The others are Boston College and North Carolina, a combined 0-6 in the ACC. A 4th opponent, Wake Forest, is 12 in the conference. But where NC State stands with regard to the sport's top contenders will be largely revealed in roughly 3 weeks. One of the most anticipated games in program history is set for November 4, with Clemson visiting Carter-Finley Stadium. The reigning national champions became the first school in college football history to beat 3 top 15 opponents in September. 2 of those wins came on the road, most recently a 3,117 victory at number 12 Virginia Tech on September 30. The Wolfpack has lost 5 in a row to Clemson, although last season it forced overtime before falling 2,417 at Memorial Stadium. NC State committed 13 penalties for 120 yards in that game, and Finley threw 2 interceptions. "We can't ever think that we've made it because we haven't," said Doran, who reportedly is negotiating a contract extension. "We're at the halfway point right now, and we want to continue this ride, and the only way to do that is to improve."